Thank you. On average, 4 people a year break their arm pulling crackers. The perfect way to pull a Christmas cracker. Tilting your end of the cracker downwards at an inclined angle during the pull. A firm two-handed grip to prevent the cracker being torn. A steady and controlled pull. The distance to the centre of gravity of the cracker. The length of the cracker. Good quality and strong materials used in construction. Avoid twisting from the shoulder when pulling. Everyone feels happier for having pulled a cracker. If it were up to me, I would introduce Christmas crackers into every large social gathering, regardless of the time of year. My favourite thing to do is to buy a box of cheap crackers from the supermarket, carefully unpick the ends, tip out the junk inside, and carefully replace each one with a small personalised gift, such as a tiny photo frame with a picture of the child or spouse inside it. Guests love that.
Bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells chime in jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air.
What a bright time. It's the bright time to rock the night away. Jingle bell.
Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and mingle with a jingling beat. That's the jingle bell rock.
Jing, jing, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell chime in jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in jingle bell square. In the frosty air.
Go riding on a one-horse sleigh.
Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and mingle with a jingling beat.
That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell rock. Jing.
Are colder now. Maybe I should close the door. And anyway, the snow has covered all your footsteps, and I can follow you no more. The fire still burns at night. Our memories are warm. Everybody knows it's hard to be alone at this time of year. It was only a winter's tale, just another winter's tale. And why should the world take notice of one more love that's failed? It's a love that can never be. I stand alone. A bell is ringing far away. I wonder if you hear, I wonder if you're listening. I wonder where you are today. Good luck, I wish you. Strength are with you for the length of your time on earth. It was only a winter's tale, just another winter's tale. Why should the world take notice for one more love that's
Okay, so it's seasonal work, the money's not great, and you'll be fired on Christmas Eve. But if you become a department store Santa, for once in your life, you're not just another fat guy. You're the most famous person on the planet. Forget Doctor Who, Mickey Mouse, and the Teletubbies. The memory of meeting you will be something the kids can treasure for the rest of their lives. It has to be the only job where the older you get, the more weight you put on, and the more facial hair you grow, the more successful you will be. You'll also need a twinkle in your eye, a taste for mince pies, and a threshold of pain when it comes to piped versions of Jingle Bells. And don't forget to brush up on current trends in toys, music, and movies. Kids will suss you immediately if you don't know your Xbox from your X-Men. So ferocious is the competition for the department store Santa. Gig that candidates are now required to sit a written test to qualify for a BSC, Bachelor of Santa Clausing. But the good news is an elf working undercover has got hold of the test paper. So steal a march on the competition with this sneak preview. Question one. Santa enters through a house which way? A, the chimney, B, the looking glass, or the C, the cat flap? Take that, the chimney. Question two. Santa's favourite Christmas snack is A, reindeer burger, B, elf fricassee, or C, a six pack of Bud and let's skip this one. Thank you. That was a tricky one. Santa rides in a what? A, 8,000. These questions get more ridiculous every time. A, 800 brake horsepower top fuel dragster. B, a sleigh. Or C, monster truck. You answered right. Four. Santa's helpers are A, elves, B, pixies, or C, small furry creatures from Alpha Centauri. Going for C then. Five, this is my favourite one. Santa is married to who? A, Anne Widdicombe. B, Simon Cowell. Or C, Mrs. Claus. Six. Santa is also known as who? St. Nicholas, St. Michael, or Living St. Anne's? And number seven. If you have answered D to all the above questions, are you A, drunk, B, in need of glasses, or C, Mr. Auden? Thank you.
Christmas time, there's no need to be afraid. At Christmas time, we let in light and we banish shade.
And in our world of plenty, we can spread a smile of joy. Throw your arms around the world at Christmas time.
Say a prayer, pray for the other ones. At Christmas time, it's hard, but when you're having fun,
there's a world outside your window, and it's a world of dread and fear. We're the only water flowing.
greatest gift they'll get this year is life. Oh, where nothing ever grows, no rain or rivers flow.
Santa Claus is coming. speed stick. She can be apple red with a ski for a wheel. And when Santa hits the gas, man, just watch her peel. It's a little Saint Nick.
So love and mercy to you and your friends too. let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself
Palm Springs, Irving Berlin looked back fondly to the White Christmas of his own childhood in New York. He actually wrote White Christmas over one weekend. On a Monday morning, he burst into his office declaring that not only was it the best song he ever wrote, but it was the best song anybody had ever written. A competitor of Irving Berlin's complained that Irving Berlin had actually used up all the holiday songs, having written I'm Dreaming of a White Christmas, Easter Parade, and so on. Experts at Music Choice, a digital musical channel, analysed all the Christmas number one singles of the past 30 years, and they identified 11 criteria for success. They included harmony, use of sleigh bells, pealing church bells, children singing, and seasonal references to love and nostalgia. They concluded that Sir Cliff Richard's 1988 hit, Mistletoe and Wine, was the most perfect Christmas hit, despite no key change for the third verse, no charity involvement, and no use of a novelty front person. Merry Christmas, everybody, is and always will be a great British Christmas hit because it is a total out-and-out party song. The song instantly conjures images of Noddy Holder, frizzy hair exploding from either side of his head like a doodle in a phone book, his fringe obediently plastered to his forehead or wedged under that ridiculous mirrored top hat. Father Christmas may or may not exist, but I believed in Noddy Holder.
It's inside that every Santa has a ball. Did you notice I had to move? Certain parts of me are larger than other parts, so I had to get out of danger, you know, just in case I went up in smoke. So, we'll sing that song again, but I really do need to hear everybody singing that chorus, okay? Just shout it out and enjoy yourselves. So we'll do the final song again, please, Mr. Moore. We've got no sparkles, have we?
Time.
choir, as members of staff that are dotted through on you saw, they're absolute fantastic routine. I taught them everything they know. Why do people laugh when I say that? Don't you think I can move? Anyway, thank you ever so much, everybody, and we wish you a very Merry Christmas. Thank you.